Welcome to the next tutorial in English language. I want to show how to construct a thread with another workbench. It is called, have a look here, it's called thread profile. And I want to show how to do this. I want to use this to create internal threads with this. And this workbench is very versatile, so it is possible to create threads of your private measurements. Okay, let's start over. I create a new FreeCAD file, and first I create my thread here. So I go to this workbench thread profile, and here you have these three profile stars, let's say, and this is normally used. I will use this in this tutorial for a standard V-thread thread profile object. This is another thing. It's a buttress thread. I don't know, I'm not a technician, so I don't know what this is, but this here is, it is interesting. It create the, then it's SP4XX. I think they don't want to use the name SPUX here, because this is the name of the screws from ABC, from Ennepetal, and I'm not living far from there, so I know this company. Perhaps this is a course they name put the A to a 4. Okay, these packs are for connecting wood, but I don't want to create a wood screw, so we start here with this piece here, and this creates such a profile. It looks like a disc, but it is no disc, it's a spline. And you can go to the property view, and these are the parameters for this thread profile. Here in this is instructions, so you can click on it and click here on these three points. Then you get this text box, and here you have the explanations how to do your threads. I don't use this thing here with bodies. I later create bodies, but first I want to create a single object I can use as a thing to subtract from my box. I want to put this inner thread in. Okay, now start. Here you have the parameters. You have a minor diameter, can make it a bit, little more visible here, and there you can choose external or internal. I choose internal. You have the minor diameter and the pitch, and here you have presets, and this is interesting. So you can have very, very many of these profiles here. And when you go here down, you have here the one quarter inch 20 UNC. It's the thread for the photographical statives to create such threads. So I use this, and now nothing happens here, so you have to type tab key once, and now you have the new thing here. So the pitch changes to 1.27 millimeters, and the minor diameter is a bit bigger. And now you can say, okay, create the helix for this. It is put in there, not in the middle of this. It's a bit shifted to X and Y. And you can look at the helix. It takes the pitch from this profile and the height is created by the parameter. It's here, thread count. And the pitch, so 10 multiplied with 1.27, it's the height here, 12.7 millimeters. Okay, this radius here, it is completely not used. This helix is not, this windings here are not used. The mid of the helix is used and everything is rotated about this center. So now we are ready. Let's create this profile. Let's have a look at it. Edit, is it everything okay? It's internal. Okay, I select first the profile, then the helix, and press this button here. It's sweep selected thread profile along selected helix. Click it, and there you have the thread cutter. So this is now, it's possible to subtract this from a box I construct now. So I leave the thread profile thing, go to part design and create a body. Go here, create a body. I don't want the body to take this sweep. I want an empty body. Create a drawing inside here. Go to the combo view, XY plane, and OK. And now I create a box here and close it. Now we can create a what's the name? A pad. Okay, make it a little so it looks good. So then press OK. Click this, this sweep here, and now you can move this a bit lower. So it's going from bottom to top, and press OK. Now to create the cutting, I do it. I don't want to do it in the part design mode, cause there I have met some errors when building the Boolean things. So I create a copy of this shape here. Okay, and create a copy of this body. And now I have here the sweep, here the body. And now I can create this Boolean. I switch to the part mode, select the body, select the sweep, and click this thing here, make a cut of two shapes. A little bit waiting, it's very fast, I think, and there you have your inner thread. Now you can, the interesting thing here is, you can export such a thing, print it on your 3D printer and try to put a stative screw inside. Is it big enough? If not, you just go to the sweep, to this South Threat Profile, and you don't have to go to the Threat Profile thing, because you have it also here, but here are the parameters for this. You switch to data, and there you have it, and you can alter this minor diameter when the cut is too small. It's normal that it is too small, because the 3D printer has the PLA or ABS or whatever you use for this. It will be a bit too small. It's flowing to the inside, and so the screw won't fit very easy. So you say okay, make it 5.5 millimeters, press enter, and now it's changed, and you have the new thread here. You print it out, try it. No, it's too small. Oh, say 8 millimeters. It's only an example to show that it really is calculated as a new thread. You see it's much bigger, and the pitch is still the 1.27 millimeters. So make it to 5.3 again. And with this thing here, you can create parts that fit to your tripod. So you can create something to mount your camera a better way, or to mount your smartphone or whatever. So if you you say okay, this is, I'm ready with this, I switch to the part design modus. This is working with this thread here, so I create a new body with selected, with the cut selected, and you have here a base feature. And now you can create more things on this, on the top of it. So create a new sketch, and okay, I want some circles here. These circles, they have all the same diameter, so make them equal, and these two are symmetrical to this mid line. These two are symmetrical to this one, and these two are also symmetrical. Now you can create the, what's the name of it, the distance. Okay, it's 40 millimeters. And this 10 millimeters. Okay, and close the sketch and create a new pad on it of 10 millimeters. And there you can put whatever you like on it. So that's all with this tutorial. I hope you like this tutorial. If you like it, you can click on abonnement and on the bell to see more of my tutorials. Okay, bye.